Hello everyone, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, we'll be looking at three new things that are added to the latest version of Laravel, which is 9.9.0. The first thing that has been added is this throw method to the pending request. Let me show you an example over here. Here is this HTTP facade, and I am just accepting a JSON, sending a GET request to this API, and just showing the JSON as a response. This API, I can show you over here. So this is the API, which is inside this api.php, and I'm just returning a response. And now if I just run this, then you can just see a JSON response over here. But let's say we had some error over here. I'm just throwing an exception from here. So we have some issues in this API. And if I just write here throw and run, then it will just return with the 500 status code, which means it will actually throw an exception. But if I don't write it over here and just run, then it will give us a JSON response with 200 status code. We don't want this behavior. So everywhere, whenever I use this HTTP facade, I always use this throw so that I'll just get an exception. And before, we had to write this in each and every places where we used this HTTP facade. We couldn't create a macro because we had to use it after we had sent the request and got the response. And now we can do that. Let me show you that. Let me just uncomment this and comment this one. I can just write a macro like this, Laratips HTTP accept JSON throw and base URL like this. Before, we couldn't write throw over here because the method was not available on the pending request. It was only available on the response. Now, after doing this, I can just do it like this. Wherever we use this HTTP facade, we don't have to write this throw. And if I just run it, then we can see this same exception. And if I again go here and comment this out and run it, then we will get this JSON response. Now the second thing that has been added is this withoutEagerLoads method to the builder. Let me show you that as well. Okay, I have just shown you here a simple example. I have this user with logins. This is the relationship on the user, and this is has many relationship. And here I'm also doing where not null email verified at, which means I'll only be getting the verified users. And if I just do first over here and refresh, then I will see a user and all the logins of that user. And suppose let's say this was a very huge query and we had this in a separate class and we are calling this class from here. It can be very, very complex logic over here. And if I call first, then we'll get it like this. But let's say in some of the places we are showing the similar data and we are calling this same thing, but we don't want to show the logins of that user in another place. And in that case, we can do it like this now. We can just do here without eager loads like this and then call first, then it will remove all the eager loads that have been set on that query. Now if I run this, then it will not run that eager loaded relationship. Now the third and the final thing that has been added is this getAllTables support for SQLite and SQLServer schema builders. So let me go here. And here, this schema is this illuminate support facade schema. You might have already seen this facade in the migration files. Whenever I do this get all tables and run, then I'll get all these things over here, the tables and the tables type. And here, let's say if I only want the name of the tables, then I could just do here, collect like this and plug, and I can just copy this thing and paste it over here. And this thing is the database name. So let me just show you that over here in the .env file and database, and this is the Laratips. Now, if I just come here and refresh, then I'll only see the tables names.